City. Look at your sales tax on all Samsung TVs, soundbars, and furniture. Save hundreds, even thousands versus Amazon, Costco, and Best Buy. Low prices and we'll pay your sales tax. The Big Screen Store.
Good morning, I'm 13-4 meteorologist Ryan Miller. We are on weather alert for the chance of some severe storms later on this afternoon. Heat and humidity will be building in rather quickly. We're looking at folks in the middle 90s, and it feels like temperatures exceeding that. Because of the heat, because of the humidity, there's a chance we'll see some severe storms. Timing-wise, we're talking between 2 and 4 p.m. in the metro. If you live east of Washington, that would be just a little bit later. Refreshing, though, tomorrow with temperatures close to 80 degrees, staying dry through Wednesday. Thursday, there's a chance we can see some afternoon storms for your 4th of July.
You can get your latest news and weather in the NBC Washington app. For now, we'll send you back to the Today Show. That is Lainey Wilson singing the hit song Heart Like a Truck off of her breakout 2022 album, Bell Bottom Country. With that record, a career that had been bubbling for a long time finally exploded. A year ago, Bottom Country earned Album of the Year honors from the Academy of Country Music, and Wilson was named Female Artist of the Year, an award presented to Lainey by her hero, Dolly Parton. Since then, she's won a Grammy and a pair of Entertainer of the Year awards, joining an exclusive club of women with names like Dolly, Reba, and Taylor. Wilson's undeniable talent and Louisiana charm, taking her to the top of the music world. After a long road to get there, Lainey and I got together in New York this week for a Sunday sit-down ahead of the release of her new album, Whirlwind, and just hours before she took the stage for a solo at Radio City Music Hall. These days, there seems to be one name on everyone's lips in Nashville.
We all know what's out of the year.
Entertainer of the Year.
Album of the Year goes to Lainey Wilson.
After more than a decade in the Music City, Lainey Wilson has arrived.
For people who think, wow, she's popped up out of nowhere, it's been a little bit of a climb. This is not an overnight thing at all. You are in the middle of it right now.
Yes, and that's funny that you say in the middle of it, because I got a song on the record called in the middle of it too. Yes, these past few years have been wild. Like just trying to keep one foot on the ground, trying to just like keep my eye on the prize and make sure that I keep showing up to do what I said I was going to do.
So what kind of album did you sit down to write? Did you have something you felt like you wanted to say?
I felt like I wanted to share a part of me that I didn't even know existed. Like, I wanted to find that. And I think these last couple of years, because it has been a constant, like, leveling up. I cannot let go of who I am to my core, because the music's not going to be the same. So, for me, when I was writing this record, I was making dang sure that both of my feet were planted on the ground.
Little monkey out here. Feel like Louisiana at all?
Feels like that.
Most of that is taxi and sauce.
Yeah.
It's the only difference.
Well, ours is tractor and sauce.
Alright.
A fifth generation farmer's daughter, the 32-year-old Wilson was born and raised in the small village of Baskin, Louisiana. Population, 200 or so. Lainey and her older sister rode horses and helped out on the farm. Their mother was a school teacher.
Being raised by Baskin and the people of Baskin are where I am right now, because it's just what all you get it up and you do what you love and you do it for your family and just don't stop.
Doesn't even have to stop the light, mm-hmm. But it does have a caution light.
It's a speed trap. If you drive through there, you better slow down.
Good tip.
I got a ticket when I was 15. Didn't even have my license.
Oh.
But yeah, it's good people. And I think when you kind of been in a place like that, you understand the importance of community.
You can
could say Lainey's career began when she first performed for an audience at her kindergarten graduation.
Was it the crowd that you loved? Was it the singing?
I think for me, the thing that like really made me fall in love with country music was the storytelling.
She wrote her first song at 9, the same year a family vacation convinced the little girl of her destiny.
Maybe it was that trip to Nashville where you stopped at the Grand Ole Opry and turned to your mom and said, this is going to be home, or this is home, something like that.
I think you know my story better than I know my story. I was looking at the Batman building on I-40, and my parents had just taken me to Dollywood. And I told my parents in the car, I said, this is home. I knew it. I knew I was going to be part of the industry. In a weird kind of way, I think they knew it too.
In eighth grade, Wilson began touring as a Hannah Montana impersonator. After graduating from high school in 2011, the 19-year-old set out for Nashville, rolling into town in a camper trailer where she lived for 3 years.
When I first got there in my camper, I didn't know that it was going to take me another 10, 11 years to even like crack the egg a little bit.
Nashville through all those years.
I think it was having like a few believers. I think God laid it on my heart a long time ago. I think it was being from a bunch of hard-headed folks. You gotta be a little bit nuts to want to do this. You do.
A full decade of hard work, rejection, and persistence finally began to pay off in 2021 when Lainey landed her first big hit, the number one song, Things a Man Ought to Know.
Well, even after Things a Man Ought to Know with our first hit, I could barely sell a ticket. It was like the strangest thing. You know, a lot of people know the songs on the radio, but they don't know who sings them. Like, I need to be on TikTok as much as I possibly can. They need to know me as a friend and then get to know my music. And so, really kind of left with that foot. And then Yellowstone happened.
Yellowstone, the hit Kevin Costner cowboy drama, began to sample Wilson's music in its second season. In season 5, the massive audience put a face to the songs when Lainey played a local musician named Abby.
I wear something flashy on stage, something fun. Crowd likes it.
Yellowstone and Lainey herself leading a cultural moment for a way of life.
Country's Cool Again, their tour and song for us. So what do you mean when you say it's cool again?
I mean, like the Western way of life and like being country. It really is a movement. And I'm proud to be a part of this generation of country music because everybody looks different, sounds different, has a different story, and comes from different walks of life. And to me, that's what makes the country genre cool right now. I got a heart
like a truck. This month, Wilson was given country's highest honor when she was inducted into the Grand Ole Opry. More than 2 decades after a childhood visit there, it set her on the path to stardom.
My favorite moment so far, hands down, my favorite moment.
You must have thought a little bit about the 19-year-old in the camper trailer.
I know, a lot of people thought I was crazy. 19-year-old Lainey. I knew it, I did, I knew it, but there's been a million steps.
You never had plan B.
I never did. I could be farming back at home with Daddy, but
he'd still take you.
Hey, he probably would. He'd take the bill.
She is the real deal. Lainey's new album, Whirlwind, comes out on August 23rd, and you can catch her on the Country's Cool Again tour through November. A big thanks to our friends at Hill Country in New York for hosting our conversation. Don't forget to subscribe to the Sunday Sit Down podcast to hear the full extended interview with Lainey Wilson. There's a lot more in there, including living her life by a simple mantra, what would Dolly do? You can find our conversation on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get yours. And next week, your favorite Sunday Sit Down with Tina Fey talking Mean Girls, 30 Rock, and the dream job on Saturday Night Live that started it all. Tina Fey, next week on Sunday Today. Let's turn now and get another quick check of your local Sunday weather.
Good morning, I'm from Team 4 Meteorologist Ryan. Don't worry, weather alert for the afternoon. Chance
what the hell?
Of seeing some severe storms, and that would be coming between 2 and 4 p.m. this afternoon, so be mindful if you have outdoor plans later today. Really hot and humid with highs near 94 degrees. Sunshine for tomorrow, and less humid and cooler conditions. We're going to stay dry through Wednesday, but by July 4th on Thursday, an afternoon chance of storms returns, and that continues for Friday and into next weekend.
Today, our highs of the week, including the story behind the American service member who gave his sister an emotional wedding surprise the night before her big day. But next, the community rallying to rebuild after a statue of the iconic Jackie Robinson was stolen.
I'm the master reptile.